many questions have been asked about the roofs or the iron sheets to be used when we consider roofing, but very small answers have been given or in this regard. This is why the Homes and Construction Show is here to answer all the questions that you may be having. And we promise you that each and every time you ask us something, we are here to deliver. My name is Hilda Kamkama, and this is the Homes and Construction Show. Join us as we talk to one of the experts from one of the leading companies of iron sheets. When looking out for iron sheets, like, what is that that can guide them on the right decision?
As a homeowner, there's a number of factors you must consider before making a purchase decision for your roof. First and foremost, you need to roof once in a lifetime. Because roofing your dream house is a cost. So one thing you must know is that you should avoid re-roofing your house. So the decision you take at a point of buying is a very critical one. Number one, choose quality. Now, quality is a very big word, but what do we define by quality? Quality is the components of your roof.
Now, zinc and aluminium, please elaborate more about that, because how can someone know that this is aluminium and zinc, or this is only zinc?
On every roof sheet, it is mandated that on the back of it, the manufacturer should indicate the components of the roof sheet. So on the back, there'll be an inkjet line that shows aluminium zinc coating. They'll even indicate the grammage of the aluminium zinc. Some manufacturers are doing 100 grams per square meter, while others are doing 85 grams per square meter. I will not talk about zinc, because zinc is just giving you a cover, but the roof will not be as long lasting as one that is coated with aluminium and zinc, because aluminium gives you that extra protection on the roof against failure. So, just to continue the lesson to our viewers, number one will be the base coating, and the second bit is the color coating. For those that will go for colored mabati, make sure that you choose a roof that will not fade, will not peel, or even rust. How will you know this? Insist at your point of purchase, ask all these questions, because like I told you, your roof will fail, and once your roof fails, you become the embarrassment in your what? In your neighborhood. But the one that has a roof that has faded, you bought
and you've paid a lot of money.
You've paid a lot of money, exactly, and that's where the pain is, which is why we need to educate our viewers continuously so that they don't make mistakes that they will regret.
You see, McLean, one of the reasons as why the Homes and Construction Show is here is to guide our viewers who have fallen trap of all those, because seriously, they don't know and they trust people with what they tell them. So today we come to an expert to tell us that if you do not want your sheets to fade, this is what you should look out for. So if you can break that down for us briefly, my viewer and I will definitely benefit.
So the market has been flooded with a number of counterfeit material. Some people are importing, others are manufacturing it here. And sad to note, the other day I saw a short video of someone that picked mabati from one manufacturer and they were painting it in their backyard. They were painting. And on painting, they are going to take it to the next shop and sell it to someone. So imagine yourself, you've gone with your hard-earned money you've saved. You've saved your money for a number of months. You're now ready to roof your house. And then you land on this scrupulous person who dupes you into making that purchase. Even forging stamps, because they want to dupe they know companies that are doing reputable products, high quality products, and they're going to now dupe the consumers out there to assume and pretend that they are producing high quality, which is not true. So every homeowner should look out for genuine stamps of manufacturers. So the inkjet runs from the top up until the end. It shows the manufacturer, it shows the components of the roof sheet, it shows the gauge, of that particular product.
Yeah, when you talk of the gauge, now trouble in the house, because that has been one of the hardest things to know. The feel, the color, what do we consider? Or how can I know that this is this gauge?
Aside from saying, checking the back of the roof sheet, I'll tell you something about gauges. Gauge is a number, but gauge is thickness. Thickness, meaning when you touch this, how thick is it? Thickness equals strength.
So it means that the higher the grammage or the gauge, the thicker the roof sheet?
Surprisingly not. The higher, the lower the gauge, the thicker the roof sheet. So we have roof sheets from gauge 32, which would be like the thinnest, and some unfair manufacturers could even give you up to gauge 34. I'm hoping that is not yet in Uganda.
Oh my god.
And we have thicker gauges that can even get to 22, 24, 26. Like this one here is gauge 28.
Is that the same gauge as this?
Yes. These are tile profiles and they are both in gauges 28. For thicker, we also do up to gauge 26 for these. Remember, like I said, the lower, the thicker it is. We have thicker material also for industrial applications. The gauge you put on your house will not be the gauge I put on a factory. Because the thicker the gauge, like I said, you must have a thicker gauge to withstand
the
conditions.
So the gauge withstands the conditions, the harsh conditions of the environment.
Harsh conditions like wind, rain, anything that would easily blow off
the roof.
Yes. Which is why we recommend that for residential purposes, you should go for gauge 30, 28, and 26. For industrial applications, you should go for 26, 24, 22.
So for the factories, we really need to look out for thicker gauges.
Yes.
I think we'll come back to that question as we continue engaging, having this conversation. I'm taking you back. You are still giving us a yardstick of what a homeowner should consider when they think of roofing or when they think of iron sheets. So we had talked about quality, we had talked about now the gauge, you had also mentioned the gauge.
I talked about quality. The other thing I want to highlight is the technical expertise of someone who is going to roof your house. Many times we want to take shortcuts. We don't want to go for experts. But you will buy a product, pick it from a hardware shop or pick it from the manufacturer. And the person that will put it or install it on your house could either do a good job or
a terrible job.
A terrible job will cause you issues like leakages, because if they do not overlap the roof sheet properly, there could be issues of
the leakage. Now that is another thing.
Or even the overall elegance of your house could be lost because of the workmanship of the fundi you have used.
We blame it on cost cutting because you see the economy really is
I understand, but like
skyrocketing.
I said, we should target to roof once
in a lifetime.
So get things right, because whether you're cutting costs, the cost doesn't go down totally. You're just trying to save a little pennies, which little pennies will cause you problems
to spend more.
So one mindset we must change is aim to roof once in a lifetime so that you don't regret, you're not incurring double
cost.
Charges. Mm. Yeah. Cheap things are expensive. Mm. So go for
expert, like go for expertise. So we have quality, we have the gauges, which you've told us. What is it with the colors?
So there's a number of colors. Colors that will suit your taste. Yeah? Colors like brick red, potter's clay, charcoal, yeah? Sky blue. There's a variety of colors.
Mm.
But like I said, you choose a color that matches
your taste.
But it's not just about choosing a color. Choose time and go for those. A color that does not fade, that does not peel. And that will answer back the question of choosing a quality brand. Yeah?
Mm.
If you look around your neighborhood, be keen on even asking your neighbors, hey, where did you buy this your mabati from? For the ones that have failed, ask them.
Okay.
They will tell you. There's manufacturers on the market that are known for high quality products, high quality colors, whose colors will last a long time. And there will be manufacturers of colors that will be fading. Yeah? So be keen on checking in your neighborhood.
Mm.
Yeah? Look out for colors that have stood the test of time and go for those.
Is this a common problem to everyone, or it has reasons as to why we always see it? Because we've moved around and we've seen peeling roofs.
Moving around, you'll find that actually in some regions, it's the norm. They will have roofs that will fade, that will peel.
Mm.
But I don't blame it on them.
Mm.
Yeah. Aside from the manufacturer, which I don't want to overemphasize on, the reason roofs fade or they peel is because of the color coating technology. Yeah. So some manufacturers will have a single coat, others will have a double coating technology. You will not compare the two. In some areas where it is extremely hot, those ones will even be prone to more fading because of the hot weather conditions. In other cooler regions, like in the west where it's not very hot, their colors could stand the test of what? Of time. So in areas which are even more prone to harsh weather, they need to be double careful on the choice of roof sheets that they pick from their points of purchase.
Mm.
Look out for quality that will withstand those harsh weather conditions.
Do the color sheets at one point fade? And if they do, how long does it take the genuine ones to fade?
The genuine ones should not fade, like I said.
Mm.
The non-authentic ones will definitely fade. We have a problem that we actually need to solve as homeowners.
Mm.
Sometimes we go to the points of purchase and we pick roof sheets from different manufacturers. We've had an issue of zebra roofs where you'll find that on this particular sheet, it's not fading. This one here, it has faded.
Mm.
It's a common problem for those that will buy from hardwares. Yeah. So you find that because you've ordered for your 100 pieces, 50 from, 20 from someone else, 20 from another person, the roof will unevenly fade. Yeah. So you'll have a zebra roof, strong, unfaded. Here it's fading. Here it's almost fading. And to avoid that, make sure that you purchase at one go.
You purchase the whole lot
at one go, and in the event that you can't purchase at one go, turn back the sheet, confirm the manufacturer.
You can still go back to them.
Yes, if you've gone to a hardware, because the hardware will stock from different
supplier
manufacturers.
Sure.
Yeah, turn back. 100 is not too much. Yeah, turn every sheet, confirm that indeed these roof sheets are coming from one
your preferred manufacturer.
Yes.
I am seeing different colors and I'm seeing different designs.
Yes.
In our homes, construction, everything, we always have different shapes, different styles of homes. I mean, we all go with the latest trend of construction. So how does that, how do we have that sorted when it comes to choosing the iron sheets?
So we've had an evolution in the iron sheets categories. From grass thatched, we came up to the unpainted. The unpainted silver sheets are what most people grew up seeing.
And they've been there for a long time.
Yes, and they also evolved to be aluminium and zinc coated so that they could last longer. So yes, they're unpainted, but they are stronger because of the aluminium and zinc coating. We also have the same corrugation or design, which is the normal corrugation. They call it ordinary or normal corrugation. At Uganda Bati, we call it resin coat. So that is what most homes grew up having. And then came the box category, which is the box profile. The box profile.
We have any here?
Yes, we have a number of them on the display. We'll be able to show our viewers. So we have the box profile. And then from the box profile, we then came to the tile profiles. Tile profiles are what I have behind me. So the tile profiles include profiles like versatile, Roman tile, and oriental. So these ones give you the design of clay tiles, but stronger because they are steel. You're able to choose your preferred shape. Shape, which is what I call the profile, and your preferred color to match the taste of your dream house.
Your building. So it doesn't matter the profile, the different profile, the shade, the nothing. It all entirely is based on your choice.
Yes, it is all. It is just your choice because when you get back to the base composition, they are all aluminium and zinc base coated, and they have the world class paint technology on them. In terms of gauges, the gauges will also be the same. The other thing I can tell you in this line is the cover width. Many times we don't know, but we have to go for wider cover sheets. So cover width is this up to this, and when you can overlap. So there's times when you feel like this product is cheaper. It looks the same, but it's cheaper than the other one. But we do not consider the cover width. So you must go for wider sheets because that will save you money. Imagine if you had to cover 2 square meters, or 20 square meters. If you have wider sheets, you'll use less
of the,
in the long run. So these are things that the homeowner must also be able to what? To know. Is this profile wider? Does it save me extra pennies that I can then maybe spend on labor? So choose roof sheets that are also wider, and this is especially for tile profiles.
So is the durability also determined by the profiles or the type of iron sheet that I go, I choose?
The durability of a roof is determined by two things. Like I said, the base components. The second bit will be the accessories that we use on the roof.
Now the accessory
bit. Something simple like a roof nail will kill your roof.
Because people don't know. I mean, we've visited people, they've just entered their homes. Okay, I'll give an example. Homes back, in the villages, they don't need, they don't put ceilings. They are calling you, are going to enter our house. It rains. It is a new house. And boom, you're all baptized.
Like I said, a simple roof nail will kill your roof. If you have a roof sheet that is aluminium and zinc coated, why are you going to use a zinc coated nail?
Because I don't.
Because the rusting will start from the nail. And because the nail has rusted, it will
like
affect the area on the roof sheet. So it will cause that katuli, that chituli, because of the rust. And the rain will just what? Get through.
Now, what is it with the valleys? Of course, you've told us the nails. What is it with the valleys? Do we use different valleys for different profiles?
Yes.
Or different gauges?
Every roof profile has its accessories. Yeah. The ridges for the tile profiles are different from the ridges for the box profiles, for example. Yeah. So make sure that when you're purchasing your roof sheets, determine or insist on choosing the ridges that will match your profile. They will also give you valleys. We have a common mistake where we go and buy only roof sheets, we forget about ridges. Or you buy ridges, but you buy a different color, for example. So you end up having an uneven roof. Yeah? Or you're buying roof sheets from this manufacturer and buying ridges from someone else.
Different...
They will not look the same. You will have ridges fading when the roof sheets are still intact.
That means that the ridges, the iron sheets, ridges, iron sheets, valleys, nails are all manufactured in one place?
Yes. You should buy from one manufacturer. Do not buy roof sheets here and then go buy ridges there. No. You will have a very uneven roof. Even the color pantones will be different. It might all look charcoal, but they'll be different. The shades can never be the same.
We talk about the affordability. How affordable is a Ugandan able to have a perfect and a perfect roof on their head?
I will tell you that there is a roof for every Ugandan out there, depending on their pockets. Yeah, I would not really talk about pricing, because once you know the value, then you should be able to choose and afford for that category. But the ordinary roof sheets will range between, when they are colored, they could range between 45 to 48,000. The box profile, and I'm talking about the 3 meter standard length, the box profiles would range between 47 to 49,000. The tile profiles will range between 85 to 89,000 shillings for every standard 3 meter sheet. And then when we get to like the stone coated roof tiles, on stone coat for every 1 meter panel piece, it could cost around 39 to 45,000 for every piece. Weather is a very important factor in terms of durability of the roof. But remember, the first thing is that you have a quality product over your head. Once you have a quality product, it should withstand the weather, regardless of where you are. A quality product should not fail. Yes, that is the guarantee, because a good quality product must withstand harsh weather conditions. You won't say that your good product can survive here, it fails there, then that is not a good quality product. It is these other fake counterfeits that get smoked out when the weather is real. If you have an ingenuine product and you take it to a hot weather area, it will fail. But if you have a good quality one, it will withstand.
Thank you very much, Maclean, for such a wonderful show and words of wisdom. I believe our viewers out there have benefited a lot. Our viewers, don't forget that this is our first show or our first episode on the roof sheets. We are going to bring you several shows when we are breaking down what you need to know about this whole process of having a better roof on your head. How you can avoid having a failing roof. This is the Homes and Construction Show. My name is Hilda Kamkama. Until next time, may God bless you.